You know, it can be pretty overwhelming for a new hunter to learn and understand all the potential rules involved with deer hunting. When and when not to hunt, how many and which deer to take, legal weapons, licenses, tags, and more. But just like learning anything new, with a little homework and studying on the front end, it will soon become routine. Regulations and seasons vary from state to state. In this video, I'm going to cover a few of the most common regulations you should expect to encounter whenever you hunt deer, and steps you should take to learn more specifically about your local regulations. A government-sanctioned hunter education and safety course is required as the first step to becoming certified to hunt deer, and will give you a head start on learning the local regulations. These are either available online or in person. Upon completion, you'll receive a hunter education card, which allows you to purchase a license in the places that have mandatory hunter education requirements. Visit your state or provincial agency's website to find out about when and where these courses are available. Wildlife agencies are also responsible for the publication of rules and regulations regarding the taking of wildlife. These publications are typically in print and electronic form. Most outdoor retailers have print materials on hand, and digital versions are easily accessible online. Be aware, however, that game laws are subject to change yearly. Be certain to research game laws yourself, and don't solely rely on others for accurate information. It is our responsibility to know the rules, because they're designed for our safety and for the conservation of wildlife that we all want to enjoy. Deer hunting regulations are enforced by wildlife conservation officers, also known historically as game wardens. As the authorities on all wildlife laws, they are the go-to resource for deciphering complex rules. Let's discuss some of the more common rules you should expect to encounter no matter where you hunt. The most basic and universal requirement is possession of the correct hunting license and tags or permits. To purchase a license, you'll need a form of identification and possibly your hunter education card number. The tags are for the species and number of animals you're hunting. Pricing and availability may vary depending on where you reside. If you qualify as a resident hunter, licenses may not only be less expensive, but additional permits may also be available. As a non-resident, additional requirements may apply. It's required to carry your hunting license and tags at all times while hunting. This allows easy identification for a wildlife officer and compliance with tagging requirements. The number and sex of deer you can harvest is often called the bag limit and is specific to the location in which you will be hunting. Upon killing a deer, it's fairly common to be required to invalidate your tag by placing it around the leg or antler of the animal. Other hunting locales may require their permit to be notched or dated on the date of harvest. Checking in a deer means to notify the agency that you harvested an animal. Some agencies require the deer to be physically taken to a check station, while others allow validation via phone or internet. In states where neither is required, hunters are randomly selected to provide information post-season. Archery, primitive weapons like muzzleloaders, and modern firearms are considered separate methods for taking deer. The size of a public hunting area or proximity to a community may raise safety concerns if rifles or shotguns are used, so archery or primitive weapons may be required. The license you purchase and the hunting method you choose will dictate the dates in which you're allowed to hunt. Simply ensure that you match your license and your hunting tool to the season that is open at the time of hunting. Fluorescent or hunter orange is a requirement for nearly all firearms deer seasons as a safety precaution. To ensure safety and proper identification of the target, hunters are restricted to only harvesting animals within daylight hours. Some areas allow that from 1/2 hour before sunrise to 1/2 hour after sunset, while others restrict harvest from sunrise to sunset. Because day length changes daily, legal hunting hours also change daily. In an effort to reduce the spread of wildlife diseases, many agencies have begun to regulate the movement of deer and deer parts. You may be required to debone or quarter your harvest before transporting across certain geographic boundaries. This allows you to enjoy the meat while restricting movement of high-risk, non-edible parts like the brain, eyes, and spleen that may aid in spreading disease. Study the local requirements well in advance of actually going hunting so that you can be sure to be in compliance and knowledgeable of all regulations when you do go. The decision to shoot or not shoot an animal should be made long before that you squeeze the trigger or release an arrow. Understanding the laws will help guide you in what you're permitted to harvest, but that doesn't always align with your personal goals or even ethics. The father of wildlife management, Aldo Leopold, wrote, "Ethical behavior is doing the right thing when no one else is watching, even when doing the wrong thing is legal." A good ethical guide to assist you is QDMA's official code of conduct. By following these principles, you'll be better equipped to make those kinds of decisions. When it comes to hunting laws and regulations, most new hunters rely on mentors, family, or friends for guidance. When that's not an option, organizations like the QDMA are a tremendous resource for steering you in the right direction. Anytime you have a question or concern on your new journey to becoming a hunter, please reach out to us at QDMA.com. We're here for you.